These volunteers aren't just publicizing a project called Homes for Haiti. They're actually building those homes. In Houston, Myrtle Beach, and this warehouse in rural northern Virginia, dozens and dozens of volunteers are cutting the wood, assembling the walls, and doing all the myriad tasks it takes to put together an ingenious structure that can sleep up to 8 Haitians. The dream for all this began with Denny Nisley, whose Christ in Action ministry specializes in disaster relief. After the horrible earthquake that crumbled so much of Haiti's capital region, Nisley wanted to jump into action.
And I began to pray, and God said, those people will need a place to live.
Nisley had no idea where to start, but felt led of the Spirit to call a building designer he didn't know at all, Ed Lloyd. Nisley told us, amazingly, he found Lloyd lived near him, had been a missionary in Haiti, and knew exactly the kind of structure Haitians need.
He sat down and drew it within 30 minutes, and he took into consideration the climate, the culture, and so many things that the Haitians deal with that we don't even know about in America.
Here's the result, a house whose pieces can be easily built, easily put on pallets, and easily shipped and assembled, all for a mere $600 each. Now, with a dream and a blueprint, Nisley still needed everything else, and it all came in a rush.
Somebody donated 15,000 square feet of warehouse, 10 acres of land for 6 months. People donated forklifts.
And volunteers came in multitudes from all over the place.
And then we just had a missions team that came. They wanted to do something for Haiti, so they came from Ohio. 30 people came for a week, and they just built homes.
Miles Carlson has been organizing these multitudes that have shown up here in Northern Virginia.
Working with volunteers, we found that it's best to keep the measuring and the cutting to a minimum.